I had my first and only visit to Six Flags St. Louis on Saturday, July 7th, 2018. And to be honest, this park was one that I initially was going to skip over until we expanded the number of days and I was able to fit it into my trip. I went in with pretty low expectations. So how good or bad was this park? This is my reflection on my day at Six Flags St. Louis in Eureka, Missouri. So after staying at a sketchy hotel and hitting a Waffle House, we got to the park way too early. We were actually parked outside the parking booth just waiting to get in. The first thing I noticed is that the park is backed up into a mountain, so the entire thing is on a giant incline. We got in the park early, but we were stuck at a staging area for about 30 minutes waiting for the official park opening. I was picking up advice from followers on this park, and the consensus was to hit Pandemonium first because of the lines that it could draw. Since it was a Saturday, we were expecting to hit big crowds, but since we only wanted to ride everything once, we decided to try to take our chances without a flash pass. Pandemonium was closed, so we walked over to the boss, also closed. We backtracked over to the very back of the park, which is at the highest elevation, to ride Boomerang, and that was open, so that was our first ride of the day. We moved on to Screamin' Eagle, which gets a lot of love from enthusiasts, but I thought it was pretty disappointing. At this point, the rest of the rides were opening up, so we made our way over to the boss. And if you've been to Six Flags St. Louis, you know that just getting to this ride station is an absolute hike. This CCI Woody is an absolute monster, and it has a unique layout, but I found it to be lacking in airtime and delivering in headaches. So RMC, if you could please take care of this, thank you. We went over to Pandemonium, which had about a 10-minute wait at this point. And one of the funny things on this ride is that on the other Pandemonium clones, like in the Texas parks, they make you carry everything with you on the ride, including souvenir bottles. But on this one, there are threatening signs about being ejected and banned from the park if you have loose articles. So you gotta love that Six Flags consistency. We then went over to Mr. Freeze, which is a phenomenal clone. And it's also interesting because it's located on an island with the park's rapids ride surrounding it. At this point, we had hardly waited for anything. It wasn't really a hot day either, so I don't think there was a rush on the water park that is included with the price of admission. And it was just weird that a Saturday in the summer could give us exclusively station waits. We rode River King Mine Train and then made our way down to the bottom of the hill, which is the front of the park, and to my most anticipated coaster of the day, American Thunder, and it did not disappoint. It was also a station wait, and I got two rides on this, and I was very impressed that it lived up to its hype. At this point, we moved on to the final two coasters in the Gotham City area, first hitting their Bat Clone, and then moving on to the coaster that I was purposely saving for last, Ninja. This is consistently considered one of the worst coasters of all time, and I didn't want it to wreck my entire day if it gave me a concussion or something. I thought it was pretty bad. There was one inversion at the beginning that tried to break my neck, but the rest was tolerable. Once was enough. We rode all of the coasters in a span of about 2.5 hours and decided to get lunch. And here's something unique about this park. We were able to use our dining pass at an all-you-can-eat buffet. It was called the World's Fair Grove, and it had a pretty good variety of food choices, like fried chicken, pasta, fruit, and other stuff. After eating way too much, we decided to go around the park looking for photo ops and getting 360 video. And on that photo lap, I stupidly decided to ride Boss for a second time. I knew I would feel bad if I only got one ride, and the line had grown a bit at this point, but it still wasn't too bad. I had basically the same experience the second time around. So, RMC, if you can please, thank you. We weren't planning on sticking around for dinner, because we were about ready to leave around 3 o'clock, but then we tried to find souvenirs. They have two shops in the front of the park, and I have never seen a worse collection of souvenirs, ever. We kept bouncing back and forth between the two, not finding anything worth the money. They had no magnets, nothing with just the park name, or American Thunder, or anything useful. We ended up wasting so much time on souvenirs that we decided to just stay and get dinner at the Go Fresh Cafe, and eventually got out of there around 5 o'clock. So, overall impression of the park. They have three unique wooden coasters that have potential, and the rest of their steel coasters are either terrible or they're clones. They have the quantity, but they're lacking the quality. I did not ride any flat rides and their Ferris wheel was closed, so I can't speak to the depth of their ride collection. I thought the operations were good. I believe they had two trains on everything, which made sense on a Saturday in the summer, despite the crowds being surprisingly light all day. This is near the bottom of my list of Six Flags parks, and I think they really need an outstanding coaster in their lineup. People have thrown around the idea of a Freespin or a Raptor, which seem like good fits. but that would just add more clones into their lineup. I think they need to RMC Boss because they can spare one of their wooden coasters and the Boss's structure gives it phenomenal RMC potential. The final coaster count. 2 on American Thunder, 2 on Boss, and 1 on Batman, Boomerang, Mr. Freeze, Ninja, Pandemonium, River King Mine Train, and Screamin' Eagle. The biggest disappointment of the day was 2 of the Woodies not being all that good. Screamin' Eagle did not deliver on the airtime, and the Boss was a headache machine. The biggest surprise of the day was the light crowds for a Saturday, and how strong American Thunder was. Let me know what you think about Six Flags St. Louis in the comments below, and if my experience was representative of what the park is normally like. Also, be sure to like this video, consider subscribing to my channel, and I will see you guys all next time.